Driving through Kampala's heavy traffic can be a challenge, with no proper bus lanes and swarms of motorcycles or border borders. It's difficult to get around on time. But one woman has devised her own means, a very rare one in Uganda's capital. Amanda Ngabirano is cycling.
Some people see me riding and they smile, they wave, they greet me, they get so surprised, especially to see me the way I'm dressed and with my handbag. And the border borders tease me a little bit. They tell me things like Gwasinga, thank you for riding, wow, that's cool. So generally, the image is not bad, the reaction is positive.
In Uganda, many people use border borders to get around. But the number of cars on the roads is increasing, and as a result, so are vehicle emissions. A 2016 World Health Organization report ranked Kampala one of most polluted cities in Africa. Amanda wants to see this change.
The air pollution, even now you can smell it. If we had more people riding in this campus, our air quality would be better. You can even smell it, even if we don't know exactly how it is. But it's very good for the environment, greenhouse gas emissions. It does not pollute at all. So when we replace a good number of cars with bicycles, we are going to have better air quality.
The roads in Kampala are narrow, and even motorists find difficulty in driving freely. Amanda finds it easy to maneuver through the traffic here in Kampala without much trouble, but she says life would be much simpler for cyclists if lanes were created, and that would improve their safety. And despite her enthusiasm to continue riding in a busy city, Amanda says it takes a lot of courage.
Routes that I like are those that are busy, because they will see me easily where there are many border borders. I like those routes. But roads that have potholes, that have flooding issues, I don't like to use them. But it's generally difficult to ride in this city.
Riding is good exercise, and for the 7 years Amanda has been at it, she says her health has improved. The mother of two hopes society can change its attitudes to bicycles, which are often seen as a mode of transport for the poor or only for men. For now, though, Amanda will continue her campaign, hoping that city authorities will segregate lanes for her and other cyclists. Isabel Nakiria, CGTN in Kampala.